When people tell you, oh, just choose a VPS, it's going to be way cheaper and more powerful than using shared hosting, they conveniently forget to mention that, yes, the VPS is $2 a month. But to really make it feel as good as shared hosting, you need to pay for a control panel, server software, backups, and security separately. So in this video, I'll save you as much money as possible by determining the absolute top-of-the-line setup using free control panels, and show you some clever engineering tricks to bypass any limitations you might encounter using said free panels. To get this data, I've installed 5 free control panels on 5 different VPS providers. So I have Hestia running on Hetzner, Cloud Panel running on DigitalOcean, Cyber Panel on Contabo, AA Panel on Vulture, and finally S Panel on Scala Hosting. Now, installing all of these panels isn't all that hard. The process is generally the same. You log into your VPS and you simply copy and paste a line of code or two to automatically download and install the control panel. The rest is either simple inputs like choosing what domain name your control panel should be accessed from, or just waiting. By the way, I'll leave the documentation for all of these control panels in the description down below if you decide to use any of them and you need instructions. After the installation, you get your login credentials and you can reach the control panel using your server IP address. The only outlier here is S-Panel. You actually can't install it yourself. The S-Panel team does it for you once you register for an account, or it already comes pre-installed and pre-configured if you buy a VPS on Scala Hosting, but more on this later. For now, all of these panels come with a visual interface to manage your server and websites. They all have file managers and they all offer automatic tools to install WordPress. So I won't be covering any of these topics. I'll only talk about what's different or bad between them, which falls into one of these categories: missing features, security issues, usability problems, or resource drain. Starting with AA panel, in my opinion, the worst choice, because it ticks all 4 boxes for what we don't want. The free version comes with absolutely no security. You need to buy it separately. Actually, a lot of AA panel functionality is modular and you have to buy most of it, like the firewalls, anti-website tampering tools, website statistics, and even SSL certificates. Additionally, you can't really create more than one account. So if you host projects that aren't your own and you want to give people access to the control panel, you'll be giving them full admin control because there's no way to create users. But what really breaks the deal for me is the fact that the company that owns AA Panel is from China. Most of the support features Chinese in the screenshots, so it's kind of hard to understand. And it depends on Chinese infrastructure, which is notorious for having government backdoors installed in everything. So do you want Chinese government on your server? Because AA Panel is how you get Chinese government on your server. And in just a couple of days of use, without even hosting a website, just the panel, I got an email from Vulture saying that the control panel is using too much CPU and my account is being limited until I sort it out. So I'd pass. Of course, all control panels take up resources by themselves. So if you would manage everything manually using your VPS, that VPS would be more resource efficient, because by using a control panel, you need more expensive configurations with more resources, because not all of the resources are going towards your projects. So there are benefits to choosing lighter panels like Cloud Panel. To see how much of a benefit you're getting, I've set up default WordPress installations on all control panels and sent 100 bots to the site to simulate load. AA Panel shows a really good result, while Cloud Panel is kinda behind. Didn't I just say that AA Panel is heavy and Cloud Panel is light? What the hell is going on? Well, we have to take into account the caching layer. AA Panel automatically installs fast CGI, so every time a user loads a page, it's saved in cache. And the next time a user needs the same page, instead of bothering the server, it's just showed from the cache layer. lowering server load considerably. Luckily for us, AA panel isn't the only free control panel that has caching support. It's just the only one, together with S panel, that pre-installs it when using their auto installers. For example, in Cloud panel, you can use a simple user interface to activate Varnish cache, and Cyber panel has Lightspeed cache support. As you can see, Cloud panel, Cyber panel, S panel, and AA panel are pretty much on the same level with cache activated. But both Cyber panel and AA panel pull significantly more power from the server to achieve these results. So the next worst choice after AA panel, in my opinion, is Cyber panel, because it often just breaks randomly. There have been errors in their download scripts where they don't work. There have been a lot of issues with spelling errors on their default installation, making management and updates hard to keep track of. Users have literally reported hacking the panel in like 10 minutes from start to finish, but these devs kinda ignore the whistleblowers. And as I'm literally writing this script, Cyber panel users just got hit with a ransomware slash crypto miner attack. 220,000 websites were affected. Yeah, I think it doesn't matter what they offer at this point. People are paying thousands just to recover their files. And keep in mind, there are both premium and free users of Cyber panel. I'm not sure that they'll ever recover from this, so personally, I'd hard pass on Cyber panel. And Hestia, they don't offer any easy to use caching solution at all, so I wouldn't recommend them for beginners. Actually, that's kind of the whole point of Hestia. It's a product for advanced users. It's more of a data visualization tool. It's not meant to automate your server management. Hestia control panel assumes you're knowledgeable enough to operate your server without a control panel, and you're only using it to speed things up, not make them easier. So Hestia control panel is a product that's best utilized by users who are already knowledgeable and most likely not watching this video. So your only two real choices are S panel or Cloud panel. To stay lightweight, Cloud panel needs to deactivate not mission critical features. You're missing out on email functionality, DNS functionality, and the PHP mod functions. It's really minimalist compared to other solutions, but that's not a bad thing, because usually you kinda want to set up Cloudflare and control your DNS through there. And for email, you can use third-party solutions that are free, like Zoho Mail. So it's actually a good thing that Cloud panel doesn't install these onto your server, because it would be a waste of resources as better solutions already exist. Everything else about Cloud panel is great, and I highly recommend you use them for a truly free solution, especially if you use providers like DigitalOcean or Hetzner, since Cloud panel has a custom built API integration with these providers, allowing you to take automated snapshots that are kinda like mini backups of your whole setup and system. I have $200 free credit available for DigitalOcean if you use the link in the description, so you can test out this configuration completely free for yourself if you have the time. As for S panel, it's a premium product. It's not missing a single feature. It's the closest thing to cPanel you're going to get. It offers both server management tools, where you can create firewall rules, change the software that your server is using, allocate resources, create accounts, and even add your own branding if you wish. And it includes individual website management tools, so you can use SSL certificates, mail servers, and absolutely every feature you would expect to have in an easy-to-use package. Additionally, WordPress installations allow you to easily stage and clone websites. It's not missing a single feature, it works with Lightspeed, and it's the fastest and easiest-to-use solution on the market by far. And it offers what no other panel has: end user support. Meaning if you host client websites using cPanel, your clients will actually have a live chat button available, and Scala hosting support will handle your requests for your clients for free. Insane. So what's the catch? Well, the only problem is that to use it for free, you would need to buy eVPS from Scala Hosting and Scala Hosting only. If your VPS runs on DigitalOcean or Hetzner or anywhere else, cPanel is a paid product. But considering cPanel prices, it's still quite a decent price if you're looking for something cheap. So there you have it. Want a fully free solution? Use cloudPanel with DigitalOcean, $200, free credits, Cloudflare, and Zoho Mail. Want a somewhat premium solution? Buy your VPS from Scala Hosting. By the way, I also have a 10% discount available for Scala Hosting if you're interested in that. And if you only want to get cPanel, you can just get it as a separate product and install it anywhere. Keep in mind that all of these control panels run on different operating systems. For example, cPanel only works on Rocky Linux 9 or newer. Hestia and cloudPanel work on Ubuntu and Debian. aPanel is suited for Ubuntu, Debian, and CentOS. And cyberPanel works with Ubuntu, Alma Linux, and Cloud Linux. Your choice of control panel might lock you into a specific operating system. But now that you have your control panel choice locked in, watch this video next and learn how to use a cheap VPS and a control panel just like this one to create your own hosting platform and charge passive income from your clients for hosting their websites.